So now that you know what the set problem is, how do we actually show that set is NP-complete? So what was the main ideas that Cook and Levin used to prove this? Because it still sounds quite difficult, doesn't it? To show that set is NP-complete, what we basically have to show is that for any problem in NP, there is a polynomial time reduction to set. And before we go into the details of this proof, I want to show you the three main ideas that are used to show this. So the first one is, well, it's not really an idea. It's the trivial definition of what it means that a problem lies in NP. If a problem lies in NP, that means it can be solved in polynomial time by a non-deterministic RAM. So why do we state this? Going back to the definition actually allows us to make a very useful observation. Because if we can solve a problem in polynomial time on a non-deterministic RAM, then that means there must be some polynomial time algorithm. Of course, that algorithm is going to use the if-better function because it's running on a non-deterministic RAM. But we know that if a problem is in NP, then even without explicitly having to come up with this algorithm, we know there must be one, because otherwise this problem would not be in NP. Which brings us to the third point, and that is the main idea that Cook and Levin had. And that is, instead of having to show that any problem in NP can be encoded as a Boolean formula, what they did is they showed that any algorithm can be encoded as a Boolean formula. Because if you can show that, well, with certain constraints, of course, but basically the idea is if you can show that any algorithm can be encoded as a Boolean formula, then you can also encode this polynomial time algorithm here as a Boolean formula, which can then be used to solve an NP-complete problem. So if you can encode any algorithm, then you can also encode any algorithm that will solve a problem in NP. And of course, we're going to go into the details, but that was their main observation. They showed that we should not look at the problems in NP, but we should actually look at the algorithms that solve those problems in NP. And we know there must always be such an algorithm, because otherwise the problems wouldn't be in NP.